Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two, showing how to create the look of a classic letterpress poster. Picking up from where we left off, open your horizontal type tool and font picker. Pick a typeface you'd like for your main text. I'm picking Great Lakes NF Regular. If you'd like to use it or any of the other fonts I'll be using in this poster, I provided their links as well. I'll temporarily make its size 163 points, sharp, and left alignment. Click on your document and type out your text. If you want to type another word using a different font, click your Move tool and press T to open your Type tool. Click on another area of your document. I'll use Steel Tongs Regular and type out my text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. I'd also like to move my first word, but rather than making that layer active in the Layers panel, I'll check Auto Select. Now, when I click on any of my text or any other element on my document, it automatically becomes active. Let's zoom into the text to see it better. To resize your active text, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. To move it, just drag it. To resize it, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag it in or out, then press Enter or Return. To reposition your entire document, press and hold the space bar and drag it. If you have more text to set, continue using the same steps. If you want to set another word vertically, click the T icon containing the two arrows, then type out your text. Continue to finesse all of your text until you like its layout, size, and spacing. To consolidate your text layers into a folder, repeat the steps that you did earlier. Name the folder Text. Make the texture layer active and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it above your text folder, then clip it to the folder. Make the text folder active and change its blend mode to multiply. Make your texture layer active again and drag it until you see your background color showing inside your text. Let's fit our poster back onto our canvas. If you want to resize your entire block of text, make your text folder active, open your Transform tool, and resize it. Next, we'll add colorful bars above and below your text. Make the top layer active, and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool, and drag a shape under your text approximately this size. Click your foreground color and pick a color you like. I'm using the same color that I used for two of my subjects. To fill your selection with that color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Then press Ctrl or Command D to deselect it. To reposition and lengthen or shorten the bar, open your Transform tool. Drag it to a position under your text and go to the middle of one of the sides. Drag it in or out. Then press Enter or Return. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Press V to open your Move tool and press and hold the Shift key as you drag the copy above your text. Pressing Shift kept the bar aligned vertically with the lower bar. Next, we'll add texture to the bars. Place both bar layers into a folder and name it Bars. Drag a copy of the top texture layer above the bars folder, then clip it to the folder. Now the bars have texture in them. I want to lower the bars and text together. I'll shift-click on the text folder to make both folders active along with their respective textures, and press the down arrow key on my keyboard. Next, we'll add off-registered text over a color star. Press T to open your type tool and click on your document. Pick a font. I'll pick Bebas New Regular and Center Alignment. For this font, I'll slide the text size to 84 points and type out my text. If you have more than one line of text, you can adjust the space between the lines by highlighting the line you want to adjust and go to Window and Character. Slide the baseline shift icon to the left or right to lower or raise that line of text. We can close the character panel now. If you want to place your text at an angle, click your Move tool and open your Transform tool. Rotate it to an angle you like, position it, and press Enter or Return. Next, we'll add a star under our text. Control-click or Command-click on the new layer icon to make a new layer below the text. Click the Polygon tool, and at the top, type in 5 sides. Click the gear icon and check star. Choose pixels from the flyout list. Place your cursor over your text and drag out and rotate the shape to match the angle of your text. Then release. The color of your star is your foreground color. If you want to reposition the text or your star, press V to open your Move tool and drag either one. Next, we'll off-register the star. Control-click or Command-click on the large T of the text layer to make a selection of your text. Make your shape layer active. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the text selection next to the star shape. Invert the layer mask by pressing Control or Command I. To off-register the star, press the right arrow key once and the down arrow key once. Let's place the top text and the star shape into a folder using the same steps as before. Name the folder and change its blend mode to Multiply. Drag a copy of the top texture layer above the top folder and clip it to the folder. Make the top layer active, which is the stained paper image. Change its blend mode to Multiply. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.